wrapping up this first hour of the Gloria Neal Show here on AM 760, 6 minutes before 8 o'clock, Thursday, January the 9th, 2014. Dying with dignity in Denver. Robert is my guest who really helped me give birth to this particular topic on this day. He contacted Norman Goldman, contacted me in regards to his situation, failing heart, and is terminal. And so as a result, you have to ask yourself this whole issue of, it's my life, or is it really? If it's my life, then shouldn't I get to decide on how I want to end it? There are many who have issues with folks ending their life when they know they're terminal. They believe that that is a decision that only God should make, that they should hang on until it's over. They should lie in a bed and waste away. Or others believe, no, if I decide that I want to seek out euthanasia, that's exactly how I should do it. It is a tough choice. I'm going to finish up the conversation with Robert. I've got about 2 minutes left in this hour. Robert, I know you were saying that some of your friends have given you a hard time with this. Do you have a support system here in Denver?
Not really. I've just spoken to like a person, and nothing really yet. Just the friends that I have here. Mm-hmm. But they're beginning to realize that, you know, hey, this is for real, and it's his choice.
Right. Right. It is your choice. How much time? I realize that it's all relative. I did a story with a woman who became a friend of mine several years back. Her name was Brenda Yurdy, and doctors had given her about a year to live, and she wound up living 2.5 years. But she had terminal breast cancer, and you know, she had taken me to where her plot was, and taken me to, you know, she had sold all of her furniture. I mean, everything was planned out, her music and her everything that she wanted at her funeral services. And she was ready. She was ready to go. She was done. She was tired, and she hadn't given up, but she was just ready. She had prepared. And, you know, you get to that point where you are, you're set. And then she says, now all that's left is the waiting. And she says, you kind of get a little frustrated with God because you're like, okay, I'm ready. You know, send the chariot.
Well, that's, I hate to say this, but having something like cancer or a lot of problems, you have a chance of getting out of there. There could be cures. There is no cure. My heart gradient was at 50 6 months ago. At 50, well, a perfect gradient is zero. Mm-hmm. At 50, you are really starting to have problems. At 60, you're pretty much bedridden. At 70, you're dying. So the way the medical situation or community scores it is at 50, you are terminal. There's no way out except for that major surgery, because the heart valve is just deteriorating. It's opening up more and more and allowing more blood to go the wrong way until eventually it's just not there.
Well, let me just say this to you, Richard or Robert, and I will say it. I thank you for coming on, and I've got your website on our website. I encourage everyone to go there, death-withdignity.com. Please donate. No amount is too small. Help Robert out. That's the least we can do. On the other side, we'll switch gears. Back in a moment.